I am Dr. Shalabh Sharma, a senior ENT consultant and cochlear implant surgeon at Sir Gangaram Hospital in New Delhi and in private practice here at Vasant Vihar. The topic for today is how do you approach a child with hearing impairment or hearing loss? Let us start by talking about a child. When a child comes to me in the clinic with a hearing loss or suspected hearing loss, a child who's not either responding to sound or not starting to speak and learn language, then we suspect that there may be a hearing loss. Once the child has come, we have to send the child for some hearing tests to confirm that there is hearing impairment. There are many tests that are done, and in small children, as young as say 3 months of age or 6 months of age or 1 year of age, a battery of 6 tests is done in total to confirm and be sure about what is the level of hearing impairment and how much of hearing impairment is there. The tests are, for example, aided audiometry, unaided audiometry, BERA, ASSR, impedance audiometry, and OAE. These tests, once they are done, they confirm that the child has a hearing impairment and to what level of hearing impairment, how much of hearing impairment is there. Supposing a child has come and there turns out to be no hearing impairment on the tests, and the tests are showing the child has normal hearing, then what could be the reason? In such children, usually that is a psychological issue or something related to the brain, wherein it could be a very low IQ, attention deficit disorder, or some sort of autism spectrum disorder, wherein the child can hear but he is not able to assimilate that information and learn to produce speech and language. On the other hand, if the hearing tests show that there is hearing impairment, then we have to see how much of hearing impairment is there to decide what has to be done. In some children, it could be just a simple thing like fluid behind the eardrum, in which case some medicines are required and usually that takes care of it. If it doesn't, then some of them may undergo an adenoid surgery or a meningotomy, a small incision in the eardrum with a small grommet tube is put so that the hearing, the fluid dries up and the hearing comes back to normal. It is temporary and it is quite common in children, especially those who have an adenoid issue or common cold, a lot of common cold. Then if we get a sensorineural hearing loss, that means a loss related to the inner ear or the cochlea, then we have to have a look at how much of hearing loss is there. If it is a mild to moderate hearing loss, that means a hearing loss or even up to severe, that means a hearing loss in the range of up to 70 decibel of sound, then we have to think of giving a hearing aid to the child immediately so that the child can start hearing sound as normally we do and start to develop language and speech and hearing. The important thing to understand is that children, when they are born, their brain is very plastic. It is very easily able to understand how to learn, to make use of the sound, to assimilate that sound and to learn to hear, to learn to speak. Once the child grows older, and if they have not heard sound for that for a long duration, say a 10-year-old child, and then we give them a hearing aid, then usually the responses are not very good. There will be some improvement, but not much. So as young as the child, as young as we can find them and investigate them and diagnose them and then put them on the hearing aids, that's the best thing for the children. Children as young as 3 months to 6 months can be fitted with hearing aids. If the hearing loss, however, is more than 70 decibel, then that means that we are looking at a more than or severe to profound hearing loss, and in which case then a special surgery called a cochlear implant surgery is done, where an implant, a cochlear implant, is put under the skin here behind the ear of the patient, and once after a 10-day period approximately, the child wears something which looks like a hearing aid again on the outside and the child starts hearing. And in this way, we are able to treat children with profound deafness or totally deaf children also with implants. And all these children, the whole idea is once they either wear a hearing aid or implant, depending on the hearing loss, they should go to normal, our attempt is that they should go to a normal school, go into normal mainstream schooling, go into a normal college after that, and hopefully become, you know, good representatives of our society, socially useful and productive members of our society, just like the normal hearing people around them. Thank you.